this video, I would like to discuss you symmetry and group theory for MSc students, that is my lecture 3. And this lecture 3 is about the matrix representations. This is matrix representations. Symmetry operators and symmetry operations can be expressed in terms of matrices. Friends, you know that every symmetry operations and every point groups can be represented by a specific matrix. So matrices can be used as representation of symmetry operators. Okay, a vector which is used to define a point in a space can be represented with a one dimension matrix. If we take one dimension, that is in x direction, if we take a vector in x direction, that is Vx, if we take a vector in y direction or y axis, that is Vy, and if we take the z, then the vector may be Vz. Then we get the row matrix like V, Vx, Vy and Vz. Similarly, this matrix can be represented like this. If it is column matrix, then we can write like Vx, Vy and Vz. So this matrix consists of only one column, while this is row matrix which is having three column and single row. Okay, now I am going to discuss the representation of symmetry point groups. Symmetry point groups, how then we can basis functions, characters and representations. Each symmetry operation in a group can be represented by a matrix transforming a particular object or basis function like the symmetry operation in the group does. Each symmetry operation in a group can be represented by matrix. Earlier I mentioned that every symmetry operation and every point groups can be represented by a matrix which transforming a particular object or basis function. Friends, you can take XYZ as basis function. You can take a position or position vector as a basis function. You can consider a rotation Rx, Ry and Rz. So rotational vector as basis function. You can take Tx, Ty and Tz, that is translational vectors. Translational vector in x direction, that is Tx. Translation vector in y direction, that is Ty. And in z direction, that is Tz. So you can take any type of orbitals as a basic function. Okay? Finding matrix representation of the operations E, C2, sigma V and sigma V dash. Friends, you know that these are the symmetry elements, symmetry operations in point group C2V. So C2V has the symmetry operations like E, C2, sigma V and sigma, sorry, sigma V1 and sigma V dash or sigma V2. In case of H2O, C2 is known as C2Z, sigma V, sigma V1 is known as sigma XZ and sigma V2 is known as sigma YZ in case of H2O. So H2O molecule consists C2V point group, and in C2V there are E, C2, sigma XZ and sigma YZ available in the C2 symmetry point group with vector R, X, Y or Z as a basis function. Friends, if we take X, Y, Z and R as a basis function, then what happens? You can see this figure. This is Z axis, this is Y and this is X. If we take a point, if we take only a point in the space here, so this point consists the coordinates like X, Y and Z. If we consider a particular point in the space and a point which are having the coordinates, that is X, Y and Z. Okay, X coordinate for X direction, Y coordinate for Y direction and Z coordinate for Z direction. Okay, the operation E has the character chi E1. If we operate this point, if we do matrix representing symmetry operations, right? So symmetry operation E has been done on this point. So on this point, if we operate E, then we will get the matrix like this: 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. In this matrix, this is for X, this is for Y, and this is the position of Z. Okay? This matrix X, Y, and Z. These are the coordinates of original. They will produce a new coordinates or new matrix X, Y and Z. Here we do only E. Friends, you do know that E, that is identity E. Identity E means nothing has been done on a molecule or on a point. Okay? Or 360 rotation on a particular point. That means rotation of 360 or nothing has been done, that is E. So by taking E as a symmetry operation, we get the matrix like this, and this matrix is operated on the coordinate X, Y and Z. So the matrix can be operated on a original coordinated matrix X, Y and Z, and they will, and the reaction gives the new product X, Y and Z. In short, the new coordinates X, Y, Z is the same that of its original coordinates because E is there. In case of symmetry operation E, no coordinate will change their position or change their direction. So this one, this matrix is known as the specific matrix of E, and the operation E has the character chi E 1. Why it is 1? Because X may not be changed after doing symmetry operation E. Why it is 1? Because Y may not be changed after the symmetry operation E, and Z also may not be changed their position and their direction after E. So original coordinates and new products are quite same, but which is the operator? This matrix is operator for this symmetry operation. So this matrix is known as a matrix representation of E. Okay, it will give one character. Okay, but with any of the vectors x, y, and z chosen as a basis function, and friends, you know that this is the diagonal position 1, 1, and 1. This position is known as diagonal position of the matrix. Okay, so the sum of the components on the diagonal position, I mean 1 plus 1 plus 1, we get 3. So 3 is the chi value of E, chi value, specific character value of E, that is 3. Why it is 3? Because the sum of the components on the diagonal position is 3. Okay, now what in case of C to Z? If we go for C2 operation, so C2 Z symmetry operation takes place there. So if we go for C2 Z, what will C2 Z do? If we consider this Z axis as C2 axis, right? So this is C2 and Z. So if we go for 180 rotation on the Z axis, right? So Y will change its position, X will change its position, but Z will not change its position and direction. Okay, so in case of C to Z, X, Y, and Z, all the three coordinates of this point are X, Y, and Z. But after C to Z, after the rotation of 180 degree, this point will come here. This point will come here. Okay? And at this position, the coordinate X will be minus X, Y will be minus Y, but Z will not change its position and direction because this is C to Z. C to Z itself is the Z axis, so Z may not be changed. So this matrix in case of E, now in case of C to Z, the matrix becomes, or matrix representing the symmetry operation like minus 1 for X, because X becomes minus X, Y becomes minus 1, X and Y are totally changed their direction and their position. So character of X becomes minus 1 here, character of Y becomes minus 1 here, but character of Z becomes, or character of Z remains as such, because Z may not be changed. Okay, so we'll get the specific matrix for C to Z, that is minus 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 and 001, which can be furthermore operated on x, y and z to give the new product minus x, minus y and z. So this matrix is a product. This matrix is original x, y and z of at this point, and this is the spatial characteristic matrix of C2Z. So the operation C2Z has the chi value 1. If z is chosen as a basis function, because y chi value of C2 is equal to 1, if z is basis function z na, z ke basis function z, if we take z as basis function, we will get 1 for z, okay. But in case of x and y, it is because x and y are quite change after C2Z, okay. So the chi value or character of x and y, the character minus 1, okay, and the sum of the component on the diagonal position, that is minus 1, minus 1, plus 1, we will get plus, minus, minus. So minus 1, plus 1, sorry, minus 1, minus 1, plus 1. Then as a result, we get the minus 1. So minus 1 is a characteristic of chi C2Z. Okay. So this is the matrix representation of point group C2V. Okay. This is the spatial matrix representation for E. This is the matrix representation for C2 and then sigma V and sigma V1 and sigma V2 or sigma XZ and sigma YZ. You can see the set of 4 matrices that describe all the possible symmetry operations in the C2V point group that can act on a point with coordinates x, y and z is called the total representation of the C2V. In C2V, this is the special or characteristic matrix of E. So the chi value of E is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3. This is the characteristic matrix representation of C2, and the chi value of C2 is minus 1, minus 1, plus 1, that is minus 1. Now in case of sigma XZ, this is the matrix representation of sigma XZ, and the chi value of sigma XZ is plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, that is plus 1 for sigma XZ. Friends, here you can see that in case of sigma XZ, as this mirror plane is passes through x and z axis, then the y may be minus, y will change their position. If you take sigma yz, which is already passes through y and z axis, it will reflect x in opposite direction. So here x will be minus, here y will be minus. So the chi value of sigma xz is plus 1, sigma yz is again plus 1. I mean, any type of sigma has the chi value plus 1. Note that each of these matrices is block diagonalized. I.e., for example, the total matrix can be broken up into blocks of smaller matrices. Friends, as you know, it is because I have already mentioned some of the information about this. How can we make smaller the matrix? It is nothing but reducible and irreducible. If you see, these all the matrices are of 3 by 3 dimension. I mean size of the matrix is 3 by 3. 3 row and 3 column, that is 3 by 3. So the size of this matrix is 3 by 3. If we take only 1, so we can make a small matrix here. We can make small matrix here and we can make small matrix here. We can make this matrix smaller by taking 1 by 1. If we draw the line here, if we draw the line here, so we get only one component in this matrix. Now, that matrix cannot be reduced furthermore. A matrix which is not reduced or which is not possible to reduce furthermore, that is known as irreducible representation. And a matrix which can be reduced furthermore, then it is called reducible representation. Okay, then here these blocks diagonalized matrices can be broken down or reduced into simpler one dimensional representation of the three dimension matrix. Okay, if we consider symmetry operations on a point that only has an x coordinate, if we take only x coordinate, then we get the irreducible representation. Irreducible representation by taking x as only one dimension. Okay, then in case of E and by taking x we get 1, so 1 is here. In case of C2, x will be minus 1. In case of sigma xz, 1 as x. If we take sigma yz, then minus 1. So here is minus 1. So in case of x coordinate, we get the irreducible representation gamma 1, that is gamma 1. So gamma 1 for C2V is 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 for x coordinate. Okay, dear friends, if you do like this information about the matrix representation of point group C2V, then you are requested that like, share and subscribe Dr. Rajendra Dave Official on YouTube. Thank you.